It's the station. Station.
Injured at work, injured while working at home, Pearson Coucher Law. 215-627-0700 or hit him up online at mywclawyer.com. Pearson Coucher Law. Workers' comp. That's all we do.
CMPRadio.net. It's the station.
Hey guys, Jacqueline Tucker here. And anytime I'm in the mood for some R&B, I'm listening to my CMP Radio app. Make sure you go and download it.
CMPRadio.net. It's the station. Station.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Mental Health Talk with yours truly. I am Christina McIntyre. I hope everyone had the best week that they could have. And so I'm going to continue the series of explaining the chakras and how they are relation to our body and ways they relate to mental health. I wanted to start off saying, what is mental health? Right? Mental health is anything that affects our mood, our thinking, and our behavior. Now, it's normal to have some changes in our, you know, moods, things happen, but if this is like prolonged, then that's when it becomes a mental illness or a mental disorder. One in five adults, suffer from mental illness each year. It's roughly about 51.5 million. So it's a lot of us that actually suffer. And a lot of times people suffer in silence because they are afraid of reaching out because of the stigma that's still placed on mental health. And so last week I began speaking about chakras and how they are related to mental health. Last week was about the root chakra, and the root was, the main responsibility was safety, security, and stability. And so this week, I'm talking about the sacral chakra. And the sacral chakra is the second chakra located in our body. It's located below the navel. And chakras, if you don't know, are energies that are in our body. They're more of a spiritual energy, so you cannot see it. But definitely you can feel it, It can move or it can be blocked, and you can feel those blockages, and they resemble real life illnesses, and I will discuss that momentarily. So it's important to pay attention to yourself and your body, because you know your body better than anyone. And then when something doesn't feel right, it's okay to go out and seek help. It's okay to go out and seek therapy. It's okay to go see a doctor just to make sure that you're on track. This is what I did before I started dealing with chakra healing. I went to the doctor to make sure everything was okay. I went to therapy. It worked momentarily. And then a couple years ago, almost 3 years ago, I stumbled upon this. I started applying to my life and I saw the benefits of it. And so I ran with it. And so I share this information with you in hopes that it connects with you and you can be on your continue your journey as well and find some healing and balance for yourself. So the sacral chakra, again, is the second chakra in our body. It's located below the navel. It's represented by the color orange, right? The sacral chakra is responsible for creativity, expression, and also sexuality. And the element for the sacral chakra is water. And we all know that water flows. So when there is a blockage, the energy can't flow upward or downward. And it can create a lot of problems in our body. So we want to find ways in order to release that energy. There are zodiac signs that's specifically associated with the chakra. They are Pisces and Sagittarius. And when the planet Jupiter is associated with those zodiac signs and this chakra as well. So when the planet is in retrograde, and retrograde is just the movement of the planet, it can create a lot of turmoil in the chakra. And what that does is it can stir up a lot of stuff. Like you may feel overly emotional. And so with this specific chakra, its retrograde starts June 20th of this year to October 18th. And during these months, it is known that it's a lot of time of self-reflection and introspection. So if you see yourself during these months looking deeper inwardly, trying to find purpose, trying to figure out your place in the world, it's because your chakra is going through a lot of changing, and especially if you're a Sagittarius and Pisces. So just be aware and pay attention to what's going on in the world and on the world outside and inwardly as well. Some foods that are good to nourish the chakra are any foods that are orange. So we have oranges, of course, a lot of citrus fruit, papayas, apricots, mangoes. Some vegetables that are good for the chakra are butternut squash, sweet potatoes, and orange peppers. So eating these foods are good for one. They help our bodies, but they're also good for balance for the sacral chakra. The basic right for the sacral chakra is to feel. So this chakra is all about feeling mentally, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. When you can't feel, you're not able to express. And when you're not able to express yourself, your thoughts and your feelings, it gets backed up. And what happens when things get backed up, they come out and a lot of times the wrong way. Like you might get angry, you might get frustrated, you might isolate yourself. So it's important to continue to find ways in order to release that energy. So when it's blocked, a lot of times we're not aware, but these are some symptoms of a blocked sacral chakra. You're feeling sluggish, passive. You feel trapped inside yourself, right? You don't want to be bothered with anybody. You distance yourself. You may avoid phone calls. You may avoid people. You don't feel like expressing yourself. You don't feel like communicating. And it's important because in order for us to get to where we need to, we need to be able to express ourselves without feeling any remorse or regret. And a lot of times this can stem from childhood. They said that a lot of times when the sacral chakra is blocked, it started when we were between 4 and 7 years old. So it's important to pay attention to around that time. Now, this doesn't apply to everybody, but this is just an overall fact. So when the sacral chakra is blocked, I'm going to read some of the emotions with it, and then I'll tell y'all about the physical symptoms that come with that as well. So when the sacral chakra is blocked, these are some of the issues that causes that. You feel burden, you feel emotional outbursts, aggression, selfishness, arrogance, hypersexuality, overactive sex drive, emotion and energy is not balanced, and you feel dependent on people a lot, and you get ruled by your obsessions and pleasures. And so when all of that is happening, if you don't release the blockage, you may find yourself pushing people away that necessarily you don't want to, but because you don't know how to express yourself, you're doing that and thinking that it's helping you, but actually is doing more damage to you. And so now if you don't release the energy, it's staying up there. What happens when something is inside of something too tight? Like if you fill the bottle of water up and if it's too much in there, the pressure breaks out. And then so after the pressure breaks, that will result in an overactive chakra, which is excessive energy, and I will discuss that momentarily. So some mental illnesses that is related to a blocked sacral chakra are schizoid personality disorder, borderline personality disorder, PTSD, sexual dysfunctions, addictions, and also anxiety is related to a blockage in this chakra, excuse me. So if you find yourself with these disorders, I urge you, you can message me and we can discuss it, but I urge you to do some research about it and how they're related to the blockage in your sacral chakra and ways that you can go about it, because everyone is going to heal differently and everyone's trauma is different. And so it's important to explore that journey on your own. Like, it's people that are willing to help or will be there to help you, but since these energies are in your own body, you have to find a way to balance it yourself. And so when your sacral chakra is overactive and this is too much energy, it can create a lot of things. And one thing it does is you feel agitated, you feel aggressive, and you feel trapped outside yourself. Maybe you're doing too much for everybody. Maybe like little things might tick you off, like maybe the garbage man was late forgetting to pick up the garbage, and so it pissed you off. You got a flat tire, and that made you mad. So every little thing, and so it's not good for your mental, but also your stress level as well. When we allow these things to build up, stress for our body, what does it do? It breaks down our immune system. Now we're allowing ourselves open to getting sick and catching diseases and stuff. And so definitely it's important to make sure that you find some resolution through all of this. It's not an easy journey because there are steps to this. It's a healing process. You have to sit down with yourself a lot of times and ask yourself why something is happening, and then find resolutions for it. A lot of times, we don't really want to face ourselves in the mirror. We're constantly pointing our finger at everyone else and everything else. So find some time and meditate. And you can meditate through YouTube. I started doing meditation without any music, just sitting with myself and allowing my thoughts to gather and figuring out why I'm thinking the way I feel. And if there's any pain in my body, asking myself why. And there are some physical illnesses related to a blockage in the sacral chakra. Give me 1 second. Okay, so if you have some of these symptoms, there could be a block in your sacral chakra. a lot of urinary problems, bladder infections, muscle cramps, lower back pain, pelvic inflammatory disease, prostate cancer, digestion issues. So these are real illnesses, real problems, but there can also be a block in your sacral chakra. And I know it's scary, you know, something's going wrong in your body. Yes, you should definitely go to a doctor and get checked out and make sure it is what it is. You may have to be on antibiotics, or you can do what I normally do if there's something going on. Like in the past, previously, yes, I used to get a lot of urinary tract infections. They couldn't figure out what was going on with me. I've been on antibiotics. I done it, and I went on for a year before. I was on medication every month for a year. And so I decided that I'm going to look deeper into it. And so the last time I had it, I tried to figure out what was going around me, what was going on internally. And I was able to figure out that I had a lot of stuff that I wasn't doing for myself. I was keeping myself away from people. I wasn't growing in myself. I wasn't doing what I wanted to do. I do holistic healing, so I did a natural drink to cleanse. And in a few days' time, after I was able to express myself, I was able to do this drink. The pain went away, the pain subsided. Now, I'm not saying you shouldn't go. You should definitely go get checked, but there are other resolutions to healing some of these issues as well. It's like you have to really believe in it, internalize it, allow it to become part of your life, and then do the things necessary in order to release the energy and the blockage. Like, you can't expect something to work if you're not willing to do the work necessary in order to get it done. And so this is like a daily commitment, right? Sacral healing is a commitment. Every day you're going to be faced with challenges, right? You don't know what part of your body is going to ache when you wake up. Now, sometimes we get normal aches and stuff like that, but if it's like over time, if it's an everyday thing, you need to look inwardly sometime to figure out what's going on, because a lot of times our inward issues, our inward problems will manifest itself into our body, right? Anxiety plays definitely a role in a lot of the imbalances in these chakras, because anxiety is because we're fearful, right? We're fearful of who we are. We're fearful of what we can become. And there comes fear. Fear stops us from growing. Fear stops us from reaching those goals that we have. And it's up to us to make a plan and then stick with it. And whatever you choose to do, you just got to see it through, right? You can't make a commitment and not do anything about it. We can say things and we can write them down, but without the work behind it, it's not going to go anywhere. And this is just like with the chakras. You can read about it, you can meditate, but if you don't put any implications behind all of this work, you're not going to see the rewards from it. So definitely sit down with yourself and figure out what's going on with your body, because you know your body better than anyone. And if you know that you're in a lot of pain, it may be because you need some healing, and this is some deep healing. And it can be painful, like definitely emotional. When I first started off with this, I definitely had, I was going through a lot. Like, it definitely made me isolate myself a couple times from people, because I didn't want to face some things that I had to deal with myself. I was too busy putting it off on other people, and that's what you can't do. This journey is about self-healing for yourself, right, to get you where you need to in life. And it's going to be some ups and downs, but I can guarantee you from my experience, it's definitely worth it. You just got to put in the work. So these are ways how to get a balance. So we know when they're overactive, know when they're blocked. So how do we get it balanced? So since the element for the sacral chakra is all about water, water is flowing. So any body of water, taking a nice hot bubble bath, replenishing your body with water. Liquids are good for this chakra, right? Any hot teas, beverages, coffee in moderation, right? Too much coffee can do a lot of different things, but any liquids that are good for your body, different teas like chamomile is good for relaxation. Eucalyptus is good for sinuses and things of that. Other ways that you can balance this chakra, since this chakra is about creativity as well and expression, you can paint, you can draw, you can write, dance, sing, you can have sex, and I would say do safely sex, whatever you choose, because sex is an expression as well, right? It's good for our mind, body, and soul. And some other ways is reciting mantras. And mantras is just sayings that you say to yourself to give yourself encouragement and to uplift yourself. I have one that I've been doing for the last 4 weeks. All I say to myself is I'm in control of my thoughts, feelings, and emotions. It's all about me. And I say that, and then I breathe in deep, and then I let it go. So you can say whatever you want. You can say, I know I'm a winner. This day is going to be great. And you repeat yourself until you internalize it and you feel it every day. Now, sometimes you're going to have to fake it till you make it, right? If you don't, if your thought process is negative right now, it's hard to go from, you know, negative to positive right away. So you have to put these in practice over time. And at first, it might seem like you're pushing yourself, but over time, it will become routine, like you're brushing your teeth or getting yourself ready every day. But it's important to encourage yourself and say these things and speak to your body just like you speak to anyone else. You got to speak positivity into yourself if you want to see the benefits of that, because our cells respond to how we think and how we speak. So if we're speaking negative things to ourselves and about ourselves, our cells are listening, and so they're going to create problems for us. And also, be vulnerable, right? So a lot of people don't like to be vulnerable because they are opening themselves up, right? They feel like they're going to get taken advantage of. They feel like they don't want to feel let down or rejected, so they retract. But you got to allow yourself the ability to express, right? The more that you hold on to things, the more damage is going to do to yourself. And that's the whole thing. Like, you don't want to cause any more damage than you have to. Like, the world is, it is what it is. It's enough. And so it's great to be good to yourself. It's not selfish to be good to yourself. A lot of times we think that if we do too much for ourselves, that we're neglecting other people. But the more beneficial we are to ourselves, we can be better for everyone else. A lot of people, you know, they like to do for people, but it's good, but it's important to take care of self first. Self-care is definitely on top. Also, some positive qualities of a balanced chakra, right? When your sacral chakra is balanced, you are creative, you're able to express yourself, you're able to take a situation and find resolutions, you're calm, you take responsibility for yourself, you're able to solve problems quickly. You're dealing with your emotions, right? You tackle things. If you have goals, you go get them. If it's a thing, a project, you can't figure it out, you'll try to find some solution to it. So having a balanced sacral chakra can allow that energy to flow. And when energy flows the way it ought to, you can create a life for yourself that would be so beneficial that you'll keep pushing yourself, you'll keep getting more determined to reach those goals that you set for yourself. And these are just some things. And these are just a few things to be aware when you have a blocked or overactive sacral chakra, right? You get lost in fantasies. If you find yourself sometimes, you sit there and you fantasizing about things, you daydream a lot. This is issue with the sacral chakra. You indulge in too much in vices, right? It's good to have vices, right? If you like to drink coffee, you like to have a drink, eat some cake, gamble, go out. That's fine. Anything that can bring you peace. But when anything is in excess, that's why addiction is one of those things that are related to a blocked sacral chakra. It's because we're doing too much. So anything in excess is not good for us overall. You can feel unfulfilled. You feel a lot of negativity, right? If you're a negative person all the time, one, you're going to push people away. Two, is not good for yourself anyway. You're going to raise your own blood pressure. You're can have a stroke or heart attack from that much stress. So definitely get inside yourself. Ask yourself what's going on. We tend to push our problems on other people, but this is all about us, right? Chakra healing is about who we are, not anyone else. We have to do the work if we want to see results from this. And it definitely is not a quick fix, right? I've been on this journey for about 2 years. And so I'm still discovering every day new things that I could work on to better myself. We're not bad people, right? We're just people that's trying to change in order to do better. If you're tired of where you're at, maybe it's time to find a different solution. And so I offer you chakra healing, right? Chakra meditations. Also, meditation and yoga is good for this. Anything that has to do with the body, your body, being able to express. So go on YouTube, look up meditations for chakras. You can do them individually, but also it's better to do them as a whole. That way you can balance all your chakras at one time. Whatever solution that you decide to do, make sure that you're committed to it. Make sure that you stick with it, right? Don't start it and don't finish. You're only doing injustice to yourself. Make this year a year that you commit to your healing so that you can become whatever you need to be for yourself. And so I thank you, each and every one of you that took your time out to view me as well. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Excerpts from a Rare Diamond, powered by BYC. Also, visit my website, www.becomeyourc.com. On my website, I talk about the mental, emotional, physical, and spiritual aspects of ourselves. Also, follow me on Instagram, becomeyourc. I have some of my poetry on there as well. And I also, on my page on Facebook, I post daily inspiration and reminders and stuff to get everybody motivated to keep going forward, right? Life is going to happen to us all around us, but it doesn't have to create chaos in us if we try to find a balanced life. Also, each and every Sunday, I will be on here, cmpradio.net, at 12 p.m. Also, download the Live 365 app and search cmpradio.net, and you'll catch me Sundays, 12 p.m., Wednesdays and Fridays at 2 p.m. That way you could get some inspiration throughout the week. Just know that this journey is not an easy one, but it's worth it. You got to make yourself worth it and know that you matter. Like, no matter what happened to you in your life, no matter what you're going through right now, there is benefits to chakra healing. It's just going to make you dig deep. And it's how deep are you willing to go in order to get the life that you know you deserve and need. It's a life out there, and I know that you want a piece of it, right? If you're tired of living how you're living, or you're tired of living what you're used to, try something different, right? Change requires us to do something different. We get stagnant and we get stuck because we're so used to things. But if you're still in the same place that you were a year ago, 2 years ago, maybe this year, try a different road, right? Try driving down somewhere different. Find a different destination. It's your choice to choose how you want to live, and so try to make the best choices possible. Also, if you're interested, I have chakra bracelets and necklaces. I will hold them up. This is the bracelet. It has all the chakra stones on it, and lava rocks that you infuse with essential oil. I have a necklace as well. They have the stones and the lava rocks as well. I have eucalyptus, peppermint, and lavender oil. They all do for different things. I created them along with my company, BYC. BYC stands for Become Your C, and C is whatever you need it to be, right? Bridging the gap between the mental, emotional, spiritual, and physical aspects of ourselves to unveil our true identity. And C can be whatever you need, right? I've been focused on change, changing the whole mindset in order to become the best version of myself possible. And every version of yourself is going to require a different version of yourself, if that makes any sense. And you can be whatever you want to be. Don't allow people to deter you from where you're going at. People may not believe in you. People may not believe in where you are. As long as you believe in yourself, that's all that matters. We only need faith of a mustard seed to get us to where we need to go. And if you do that, then you can climb mountains. You can overcome anything. Just start somewhere, right? Start your healing process somewhere. And allow the chakras to be a place where you start at. It can manifest into something better, and it can take you into a different reality, right? Create your own reality. That's what the chakras do for me. They help me create the reality that I want to live in. And ask yourself, what reality do you want to live in? Thank you all again. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to share. Remember, you are worthy and worth it and valuable. You're an intricate part of this universe, and you matter. Fall in love with yourself so the world can fall in love with you. Till next time, everybody. Thank you. Move, 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 you can hate.